हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाई द एक्चुअल साइकिल डिफर्स फ्रॉम आइडियल साइकिल. ओके, सो रीजंस फॉर डेविएशन ऑफ एक्चुअल साइकिल फ्रॉम थ्योरेटिकल साइकिल. देर आर सो मैनी रीजंस why this cycle differs. Okay, why this differs? See, if we see the PV diagram of Otto cycle that we have already seen, see, theoretical means like this, that 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. Okay, so this is 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. That is volume constant. This is also volume constant. This is compression and this is like this. And this is expansion, PV to the power gamma is equal to C. Okay, this is heat addition and this is heat rejection. Now, this is theoretical cycle, which we have derived Otto cycle efficiency. Theoretical cycle. Actual cycle will be, see here, due to so many reasons, that reason we are going to discuss in this session. So, PV. Okay, so like see 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, okay, like this. So this is theoretical cycle and this is actual cycle. Now this is nothing but PV to the power gamma is equal to C, compression. Okay, this is expansion, that is also PV to the power gamma is equal to C. This is heat addition process and this is heat rejection process. Now, what are the causes? What are the reasons? The actual cycle differs from the theoretical cycle. So, deviation of actual cycle from theoretical cycle. Number one, we have considered that only air is, remember, assumption also was, it behaves like a perfect gas. That means it behaves like for behaves for a air. But at entry, not only air, but air plus fuel, that is called mixture, enters during suction stroke. Okay, that is one reason why this cycle takes place. This actual cycle figure will be this one. So we assume that air enters into the cylinder while suction, but actual condition will be air plus fuel, that mixture enters during the suction stroke. So one reason is this one. Another reason, heat addition, that is heat addition is not from directly reservoir, that is not from directly from reservoir. Remember, heat addition is not directly from heat addition is not directly from reservoir. Instead, heat addition is from fuel, burning the fuel. So burning the fuel, it is not coming to the reservoir, that combustion chamber, due to reservoir, from the reservoir, but it is due to burning of the fuel. Due to that also, this figure, theoretical figure, and this is actual figure, differs from one another. Another is, see, this compression and expansion, we have assumed that adiabatically. That means, no heat transfer takes place, but in actual practice, heat transfer is continuous. See, it should not be actually during adiabatic process, whether it is compression or expansion, during the both process is adiabatic, that means there is no heat transfer, it should not take place. But since the system is here connected to one another, heat transfer is continuous and it is not like what we have assumed in theoretical cycle. Okay, next point, see, suction and compression we are assuming at suction and exhaust. Suction and exhaust we are considering at atmospheric. But actually it is not possible. Why? Because see, at entry condition, this is entry condition, we can call it a 0 to 1, okay, and this is 0, 4 to 5. This is our suction condition and this is exhaust, okay. And in theoretical cycle, we were considering that it will take place at atmospheric condition. At the same pressure, it cannot suck, it always goes from. Remember, there should be pressure difference or temperature difference, then only fluid will go from one place to another. So from higher temperature to lower temperature, so this is not suction exactly, this suction is not atmospheric. Similar way, exhaust also very high temperature, it should be atmospheric. So exhaust condition exactly will not be atmospheric. So suction and exhaust atmospheric condition we have shown in theoretical diagram. In actual practice, it is not atmospheric, okay. In atmospheric condition, suction and exhaust both is not possible. Another, so many losses are there. There are so many losses due to which, like frictional losses, leakages, different leakages will be there. See, while deriving the thermal efficiency of the engine, we did not consider any type of losses. That means, if no losses were considered there, but in actual condition, there will be so many losses, frictional losses, leakage, blow off losses. Due to that one, this actual cycle differs from theoretical cycle, okay. There are so many other reasons also, but these 5-6 points are very important. So let us sum up what we have studied in this class. Deviation of actual cycle from theoretical cycle. See, this is a theoretical cycle PV diagram of the Otto cycle, this is actual cycle. So why this happens? See, first of all, at entry condition, we have assumed that only air enters into the cylinder, but in actual condition, no only air, but air plus fuel enters into the cylinder, okay. So mixture is entering into the cylinder during the suction stroke, okay. Heat addition is not directly from reservoir, instead of it is from, heat addition is from burning the fuel. So heat is added due to burning the fuel. Compression and expansion adiabatically we have assumed here, but it is continuous process. Adiabatic means no heat transfer should be there, but heat transfer will take place there. But in actual practice, heat transfer is continuous, and due to that one, actual diagram will be like this, okay. And suction and exhaust we have assumed in theoretical cycle that it will take place at atmospheric condition. But we know, unless there is difference in pressure and temperature, neither it can enter nor it can come out from the cylinder. So it is not actual at the atmospheric condition. So suction and exhaust should be at atmospheric condition. In actual practice, it is not atmospheric condition, okay. So that is the difference. Another, so many losses are there, frictional losses, leakages, blow off losses. All these losses, due to these losses, actual cycle will differ from theoretical cycles. What are the reasons are there? That reasons I have mentioned here, 5 reasons are there. So you may get a question in MDU exam, why the actual cycle differs from theoretical cycle. So you have to give this diagram, as well as you have to write these points all point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points. Due to these reasons, actual cycle differs from theoretical cycle. Okay. So, rest of the thing I will discuss in next class. Thank you.